When it comes to troubleshooting some of the most common computer hardware issues, it's usually down to two components, and that's the RAM, also called memory, and the hard drive or SSD. Now, obviously, a computer has a lot more components than just RAM and a hard drive or SSD, but usually when you're troubleshooting hardware issues on your computer, you definitely want to have a look at both of those components as well. Now, with that being said, in this video, I'm going to show you how you can test the RAM or memory in your computer so you can be absolutely sure that you don't have any errors when it comes to your RAM or memory. Now, before I show you the software that we're going to be using to check the memory for errors, I just want to mention that Windows has a built-in memory diagnostic program. And you can just find it by doing a search for it, where it will basically give you these two options, where you can restart now and check for any memory issues, or you can check for problems the next time you restart your computer. Now, the only reason I'm showing you this is because you shouldn't be using this to check your memory for any issues. It just doesn't test the memory thoroughly enough, and it might give you false negatives and say the memory is fine when it actually isn't fine. But what you should be using is memtest86 by Passmark Software. What we're basically going to do is we're going to create a USB flash drive that we can use to test the RAM in our computer for any faults. So you will need a USB flash drive for this. And as you can see, memtest86 uses algorithms that have been in development for over 20 years. So to download it, just go ahead and click on this download button here. Now you get a pro version of memtest86 that you can buy, or you can download this free version. And this video isn't sponsored at all. This is just the software that I've always been using to test the memory in computers. And that's why I'm telling you to use it. Now, in this video, I'm going to be using the free version, which at the time of this recording is version 11 of memtest86. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that to start the download. But one thing I just want to mention is if you scroll down on this page, you're going to see that this version of memtest only supports UEFI boot. And on computers that don't support UEFI, it's not going to boot properly. In that case, you need to download the older version of memtest86 instead, which is version 4. And you can find that by scrolling down on this page, and you're going to get to the older versions section. And then you can just download version 4 for Windows or version 4 for Linux or Mac. And the one that you want to download for Windows is this image for creating a bootable USB drive. If you go ahead and download that, if you have an older computer that does not have UEFI boot, then you can follow the same instructions that I'm going to be giving you next. And you're basically also going to find this memtest86 USB zip file. So I'm going to click on that to show it in my downloads folder, which in my case is the desktop. And this is a zip file. So to extract it, I'm just going to right click on it, then click on extract all, then click on extract so I can get the files extracted to the desktop here in my case. And it should automatically open the folder on your computer as well, like it did here. Now, to create the bootable USB drive to test your RAM for errors, you need to double click on this image USB executable file, and then it's going to open this window. So up here, you're going to see in step one, you need to select the USB drive that you want to use for this. So I only have one USB flash drive attached to my computer, so I'm just going to go ahead and select that by checking this box here. So in step two, you need to select write image to USB drive, which is selected by default. On the right here, you'll also have some other options. You don't need to check any of those boxes, just leave it on the defaults. And then in step three, you need to select the image that you want to write to the USB flash drive. And in our case, it's going to be the memtest86 USB image. Now, it should be detected by default. You shouldn't have to go and browse for it. But if you need to browse to the directory, you can just click on the browse button and then go ahead and select it again. But like I said, by default, it should already be in the directory where you have it saved and extracted to. Once you've checked all of this, you can just click on the write button. It's going to give you this confirmation or verification window, giving you a summary of what's about to happen. And if you're sure that you want to do this, I'm just going to select this box so it doesn't prompt me for this again, and then just click on yes. Then you're going to see this warning that says the USB flash drive will be formatted, meaning the files that you have on that USB flash drive will be deleted and you won't be able to get it back. So if you have any important files saved on the USB flash drive you're using for this, you need to go ahead and make a backup of those files or copy it to another device or your computer so you can get access to those files again, because like I said, they will be deleted from the flash drive. So once you're happy with that, you can just click on yes to continue, and then it's going to start creating the memtest86 bootable USB flash drive. Now I'm just going to speed this up in the video, and then I'll show you how we can boot from it and do a test of our RAM. So once it's finished, you're going to see this message that says imaging has been completed. Then you can just go ahead and click on OK, and you can click on exit to close this window here. One thing I forgot to mention earlier is that the memtest86 file is about 1 gig in size, so you don't need a very big flash drive for this. A 4 gig flash drive will do, although these days I don't even know if you still get 4 gig flash drives, but I just wanted to mention that the file is only 1 gig in size. So once you have that USB flash drive, you can go ahead and boot from it. And to do that, you'll need to plug it into the computer that you want to test the RAM of. And then once it's booting up, you need to press the boot menu key. In my case, it's F12. And then you need to select this USB flash drive as the boot device. So I have version 11 of Memtest, which is the version that only works on the UEFI boot mode. So I'm going to select the UEFI boot mode of the generic USB flash disk and then just press enter. And then it should boot to the Memtest86 application. And as you can see, it's booting from that USB flash drive now. And in a second here, we're going to see the Memtest86 test start running. So at the top here, you can see the pass percentage, and the pass percentage is the overall percentage of the RAM test. And then the test percentage below that is the current test percentage that it's running. Then you can see the brand of the RAM. Right now, I've got Transcend RAM installed in this computer. And then you also see some information with regards to the CPUs. And then below that, you've got the total time this test has been running, the address mode, and then how many times it's passed. And then right next to that, you'll see errors. So what you should do now is just leave this test to run until it passes at least 4 times, as you can see down there, and it needs to pass without having any errors. If it has any errors, then it means you have faulty RAM installed in your computer. And in that case, if you've got more than one RAM module installed, you would power off your computer, then you would unplug all of the RAM that you have installed in your computer. You would start testing the RAM modules individually. So you would only insert one back into the computer, then run this test again. And then you can also leave it to pass 4 times, or if it takes a really long time to complete the test, you can let it pass 2 times. But if you have the time to thoroughly test the RAM, leaving it to pass 4 times is probably ideal. But sometimes I just leave it to pass twice. That's also fine. And then you would basically go through all of your RAM modules to see which one gives you the errors. Another thing you might also want to try is testing one RAM module in all available slots on the board, because it might also be a RAM slot that's faulty, although that's not as common as having faulty RAM. So basically, if you found any errors while testing the RAM of your computer and you have multiple RAM modules, in that case, you would need to go through each one of them individually, like I just explained, and then find the faulty RAM module or faulty slot on the motherboard if it is a faulty slot. But if you want to cancel the test, you can just hit escape on the keyboard. Then you'll find this menu here, and then you can either skip the current test, you can end the test, or you can continue. So I'm just going to select 2 to end the test. Now, obviously, I have this message here that says the test is incomplete because I cancelled it before it could pass. But I'm just going to press any key to continue, and then you'll see a summary of the results of the test that you just ran. But I'm just going to press any key to continue. And then you also have the option of saving an HTML report for this test. If you want, you can just press Y for yes. And I'll go ahead and do that. And then you'll get to this Memtest86 screen here, where you can basically run another test or you can do a benchmark on your RAM. But I'm just going to exit by pressing X. And then it's automatically going to restart in a few seconds. But I'm just going to click on shutdown, which will turn off the computer. But that is basically how you can test the RAM of your computer and determine if you have any RAM issues. Usually when your computer is acting funny, you'd want to test the RAM as well, just to make sure that everything is working properly. And using the method I showed you in this video should be really helpful in determining if you have any memory issues on your computer. Now, I'm also going to be creating other videos showing you how you can test other components in the computer to see if they have any issues. And you can find a link to that playlist in the description of this video. But I really hope this video has been useful. If it was, please like the video. And if you want to support this channel, you can consider becoming a YouTube member. But with that being said, thanks so much for watching. I'll talk to you guys soon.